All right, everybody. Hey, y'all listen up, y'all listen up. All right, we've got a game for you guys called the Wheel of Musical Instruments. So if you're participating in the game, come on down. Hey, we also need one volunteer. If you're like musically inclined. Hey. Ford? All right, actually, I'm sorry, man. Hey, here you go, hold. Hey, do any of y'all do, what's it called, like, blowing?
Max is in, like, band.
All right, everybody. So what's going to happen is we're going to have our eight contestants. They're going to come up here one at a time and spin the wheel of musicality. And they're going to land on an instrument, and I'm going to tell them a song that they have to play, and they just have to try and figure it out, basically. And they're going to play it for you guys, and then Josh will put up a kind of clue, a genre. It'll give you the genre of what they're trying to play, and if you guess what they're playing, you'll be given some Yeti bucks. And the person, if you guys correctly get someone to guess your thing, then you will also be given Yeti bucks. I think that's it. Okay, who wants to go first? You wanna go? All right, Carly. Spin the wheel. Yes, you do. All right, I need complete silence so you can listen to Carly. There's a clue on the screen. Give her a second. She's musically. Oh, that's actually good. Anybody? It's Bradley, you have a guess? Yeah. Yes! Bradley, Kirby, and Carly Lawson, the duo. Hey, yes. I don't know how much. Yeah, give Carly 10. All right. 10 Yeti bucks. Bradley, come on down or meet Becky halfway. 5 Yeti bucks coming your way. All right. You want it, Holden? You ready? Are you ready? Yeah. I'm gonna let it. All right, give it up for Holden, the next contestant. Oh, he got guitar! All right, 1 second. Let me take these off and keyboard. All right, everybody.
Okay.
Sweet Home Alabama! Woo! And give it up for Holden, the guitar hero, baby!
Big wheels keep on turning. What?
All right. Next up, who will it be? Let's go back over here. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo, pick a tag and let it go. All right, give it up for Braden Kirby. Okay, he got the bongos. Yes. I'll bring it. All right, here we go. Tegan? Tegan? Not a guess. We'll give it a take in Andrews. Three for three. That a baby. All right. Next up, I'm selecting Max Gregory to go. Max Gregory, everybody. The bugle, Max Gregory, the bugle man. All right, y'all listen up.
Oh my Jesus.
Might be a, nope. Yes, taps. Wow, Max. That was impressive. Show some respect. No. Yeah. Who got it? Oh. All right. Give it up for Eli Kibbe. Looks like he got the tambourine.
It's so okay, okay. All
right. Jingle Bells is correct.
The word.
All right, give it up for Silas Jackson. The recorder.
Is that yours?
the recorder, the instrument we all had in fifth grade and then lost. Hey, y'all listen up. You're about to hear the song of a lifetime. Yes, Chris White. All right, second to last, Aiden Adcock.
Spin that wheel, baby. Spin it up.
The Kalimba. All right, listen up. Aiden, oh, that's really, you wanna, yeah, no, it's not Jaws. Aiden, what's wrong? You've never played the Kalimba before? All right, it was, what? How did y'all not guess that? That was spot on. All right, Naomi Cartwright, spin that wheel.
Spin that wheel, spin that wheel, spin that wheel.
I wonder what it could land on. Ooh, ukulele. What is it? Yes, Kate Jackson, what a yes. All right, give yourselves a round of hand. Give these guys a round of hand. I would just like to point out that you guys correctly guessed every single one except for Aiden Adcock. So we're all ashamed of you, Aiden. Give up music forever.
Hey. Hey, everybody. How y'all doing tonight? Hey, real quick, we're going to get started in about 10 minutes, but before we do, you've got like a 10-minute break if you want to get up, hang out, meet some people. If you brought a guest with you tonight, be sure to come up, find me, and get a guest card. If you do, you fill one in for us, guest, you get a free Chick-fil-A gift card. That's pretty sweet, right? So do that if you would. You guys have about 10 minutes. You're dismissed for 10 minutes. Thank you. All right. Hello, family. That's pretty good. I'll take it. Hey, good to see everybody tonight. We are thankful that you're here. Welcome to FWEDNESDAY. Hello, friends. Who brought a FWEDN with them tonight? Anybody bring a friend? Good. Thank you for doing that. I do want to let you know, we'll take care of this a little later if we missed you. Listen up, please. I do want to let you know, we'll take care of this later on if we missed you, but at the end of class tonight, if you're a guest in the room and we've not given you a t-shirt and we've not given you a Chick-fil-A gift card, that needs to change. So at the end of the night, I'll make an announcement one more time. We'll make sure we give out all these guest cards, get you some shirts and Chick-fil-A cards. Thank you for being here. We have a few announcements to share, and we've got a pretty packed room tonight. Thank you all for being here and for bringing friends. All right, we'll take just a minute and give you a couple of shout-outs. I don't know if Sam Oliver's here tonight. Is Sam here? We're going to keep shouting out Sam until he shows up. We tried last week. We missed him. We'll try again another time. But the second shout-out goes to Darian Rogan. Where are you, Darian? Darian Rogan, ladies and gentlemen, was the recipient of the Western Kentucky Youth Camp scholarship. Congratulations to Darian. So shout-out to him. All right, this week, this is a pretty cool, I guess, photo of the week. You might not can see it real well, but on the top, you got, let's see, Riley, Adam, Trent, Dalton, Emma, and Audrey, and then as kids, and then all grown up with their graduation gowns on. Yeah, aw, isn't that sweet? Pretty cool. So congratulations to all of our graduates. It's coming up soon. All right, let's keep moving. We do have the Single Moms Car Care Clinic coming up in like 2 weekends, the 13th. So if you're interested in helping out, maybe you could use some community service hours, or maybe you just want to do something kind for your neighbor. They always need help with child care. They need help washing cars and things like that. It's a lot of fun. If you're free on that Saturday, you can go to Youth Group Central, and you should be able to find all the information you need there. We'll show you that again later. So stay tuned. Next slide. Dig, let's go upstairs to Josh. Awesome. So rising freshmen. Very good. Rising eighth graders rising up to become freshmen are invited. And again, those are high school devotionals for the boys. Boys high school devos every week. Probably an impact slide if I had to guess coming up. Very good. So yeah, ignore most of the stuff on the screen except the time is correct. And it'll be at the Kef's house. Becky's speaking. And I guess, can they still dress cute, though? Is that okay if they still do that? Okay. All right. Next. All right. This will be the final time I will announce this. So if we have any juniors who are going to be seniors next year, so that's our rising senior class, if you're interested in being one of our student youth interns, we're going to start setting up interviews probably next Wednesday. So if you would be interested in that and you haven't let me know, juniors, we need to know because it's time. So we're going to start lining up interviews. We're looking forward to that and a lot of fun. So please let me know if you're interested and we'll set something up. We announced a couple of weeks ago that our camp theme is sweet. It's going to be a sweet year of camp. It's going to be awesome. So sign up for camp. You can do that. Well, there's a link on Youth Group Central. But if you want to go to Western Kentucky Youth Camp site, you can do that too. But anyway, that's through from 4th to 12th grade. This year at camp, the first full week in June, sign up. It's going to be amazing. Oh, man, lots of announcements. Are we done? Sneedville, anything you'll say about Sneedville? It says what to do on the screen. If you're interested in the Sneedville mission trip this summer, do what the screen says. And then finally, everything I just said can be found at Youth Group Central. If you'll scan the code on the screen, it'll take you to like our whole calendar for the youth program. All the information, all the details you need is there and updated very frequently with new events and information that you might need. And also there you can scan it and you can check in and do the digital passport thing. Stay tuned on what the final excursion will be. Probably going to happen sometime in June, and I promise you're going to want to be here for that. So use the passport, check in, and I think we got a few more Wednesdays and Sundays left until this season wraps up. All right, is that all? I think that's just about everything. Tonight, we are so excited to have Mr. Chris McCurley here with us tonight. We're thankful for Chris. Chris recently moved here from Texas. He preaches at the Walnut Street Church of Christ. The biggest news in Chris's life that he's super excited about is for the last 6 months while he's been living in Dixon, his wife has still been in Texas. And so now, like tomorrow, husband and wife get to be reunited. So excited for that. And so been a long six months for him, but he's excited to finally have her back with him by his side. Hey, let's have a prayer tonight for Chris, and then he'll come up and speak to us tonight. Thank you for joining us this evening. Let's pray. Father, we are so thankful that we have another chance tonight to come together to study your word. Thank you for every friend who's here. Thank you for our friend, Chris McCurley. We're thankful that he could join us. Thankful for the work that he does, the talents that you've given him, the way that he uses them to serve you. We're so thankful for the fact that he and his wife get to be back together. Thank you for the two of them and the way that they serve you. And we just pray that you'll continue to bless their work at Walnut Street. And we pray also you bless the work at Mount Juliet. We're thankful we get to be a part of your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thanks, sir. You know, long, long ago in a galaxy far, far away, there was a time when you would go to the beach and you would just soak in the scenery. You would stand on the shore and you would watch the sun set on the horizon. You would listen as the waves crashed into the sand. There was a time when you would drive through the Rocky Mountains and you would stop, pull over, and get out and just soak in the scenery and gaze upon God's creation. There was a time when you would go to Hoover Dam, Old Faithful, the Grand Canyon, and you would just look and you would gaze upon God's beautiful creation. Now, our first thought is, I should take a picture of me, right? I'll take a picture of me and I'll have the Grand Canyon or Old Faithful or whatever in the background. They even got these sticks that you can place your phone on the end of and hold out in front of you so you can get more people in the picture. Do you know what we call these pictures? Selfie. So you've heard of the term selfie, right? You heard of this term? Narcissism. Anybody know what that means? That's what you call it when you take a bunch of pictures of yourself. And you know, now we call them Facebook or Instagram. And I say that sort of tongue-in-cheek. I'm not trying to condemn anyone who takes selfies, because if you follow me on Instagram, or I know you're not on Facebook, but I have a lot of selfies. I take a lot of pictures with me and fish or animals that I've killed and that I plan to eat. So I'm not condemning you. You know what? Just take a selfie. How's that? So I can put it on Facebook. Does that sound good? All right. You know, we live in a selfie world, and social media has only heightened, further exposed, and encouraged this reality. We're constantly checking our Instagram or Snapchat or whatever it is, seeing if anybody snapped us back, anybody's liked or commented on our post. What is driving us to focus so intently on ourselves and what people, even total strangers sometimes, think about us? I'm sure you know this, but on your iPhone, if you have an iPhone, there is a feature called selfie mode. Do you know that? So you can hit the camera app, you can go in, swipe to portrait, you can, you know, get the, you know, camera facing you, and you can actually snap a selfie with one of the volume buttons, right? But did you know that selfie mode doesn't just apply to your iPhone? Many people, many Christians, in fact, walk into our churches every week in selfie mode. How do you know if you're stuck in selfie mode? You're chronically late, and you make everybody else wait on you. You're a bad listener. Your lips won't form the words, "I'm sorry." You become moody when someone else gets the spotlight. Another one is this. You come to church on Sunday with your basket empty, expecting everyone to fill it, rather than coming to church with your basket full, ready to empty it out. I sure hope they sing the songs I like. I sure hope that the sermon doesn't run long. I sure hope that someone doesn't answer the invitation so that we can get out of here on time. Every Sunday, there are countless Christians who walk into worship in selfie mode. And the best thing that all of us could do, starting right here, right now, tonight, is to turn off selfie mode and walk out of here different. I want you to notice what David writes in Psalm 27, verse 4. One thing I have asked from the Lord that I shall seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to meditate in his temple. David says, I just want to be with you, God. That's it. I just want to be with you. I just want to look at you. I just want to be in your presence. That's all I want. No selfies, just you and me, Lord. And then notice what John writes, Revelation chapter 5, starting at verse 11. Then I looked, and I heard the voices of many angels around the throne and the living creatures and the elders, and the number of them was myriads of myriads and thousands of thousands, saying with a loud voice, worthy is the Lamb that was slaughtered to receive power, wealth, wisdom, might, honor, glory, and blessing. And I heard every created thing which is in heaven or on the earth or under the earth or on the sea and all the things in them saying, to him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be the blessing, the honor, the glory, and the dominion forever and ever. And the four living creatures were saying, amen, and the elders fell down and worshiped. You know what this tells me? It tells me that there are no mirrors in heaven because no one was looking at themselves. Everyone was focused on God. Because everyone there understood something that we all need to understand as well, and that is, there is someone so much more beautiful to look at. Don't get me wrong, you're all gorgeous. But there's someone so much more beautiful to look at. Someone so much more beautiful than even you, right? Let's focus on God. Let's focus on being in His presence, the beauty of our Heavenly Father. Instead of always being stuck in selfie mode, stare at Him. Focus on Him. Paul wrote these words in Philippians chapter 2. Therefore, if there is any encouragement in Christ, if any consolation of love, if any fellowship of the Spirit, if any affection and compassion, make my joy complete by being of the same mind, maintaining the same love, united in spirit, intent on one purpose. Then he says, do nothing from selfishness or empty conceit, but with humility consider one another as more important than yourselves. Do not merely look out for your own personal interest, but also the interest of others. Have this attitude in yourselves, which was also in Christ Jesus, who, as he already existed in the form of God, did not consider equality with God a thing to be grasped, but he emptied himself by taking the form of a bondservant and being born in the likeness of men. And being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself by being obedient to the point of death, death on a cross. Paul says, don't come in here in selfie mode. And can you imagine what our churches would be like if everyone followed this? What if everyone walked into worship and out of worship, focusing only on God and themselves? Can you imagine how different this church would be? Can you imagine how different this youth group would be? Can you imagine the impact that this group could make in the world around us? Because after all, this isn't about you anyway. The focus is not you. Look at God. Look at others. Let that be your focus. Because that's what's pleasing to God, and that is the secret to joy and contentment. I want you to do me a favor. Turn with me in Hebrews chapter 5. I'm going to have somebody read it, okay? So I'll give you a second to turn there, if you would. Go ahead. Turn there. Are we there? What's the matter? Is this weird? Well, so is this. Somebody read Hebrews chapter 5, starting in verse 12. Anybody? All right, I'll read it. For though by this time you ought to be teachers, You have need again for someone to teach you the elementary principles of the actual words of God, and you have come to need milk and not solid food. For everyone who partakes only of milk is unacquainted with the word of righteousness, for he is an infant. But solid food is for the mature, who because of practice have their senses trained to distinguish between good and evil. I shouldn't be drinking from a baby bottle. That's weird. It's unnatural, right? And you know what else is weird and unnatural? For someone who should be a mature Christian to continue sucking from a baby bottle when they should have moved on to solid food a long time ago. But for some, this is the only time they eat. And hopefully that's not the case with you. Hopefully this is not the only time you eat. For some it is. For some, it's a weekly feast, one night a week, Wednesday night or Sunday morning, they come in. And they're kind of like that baby bird that holds their mouth open and mom drops the worm in. That's weird, right? For us, that's unnatural. But that happens so often in our churches, in our youth groups, where we just sit there with our mouths open. Feed me, feed me. No, not that. I want something else. Wah, right? When at some point, you've got to learn to feed yourself. You can't always be a passive recipient. You've got to be an active doer as well. That's part of what it means to empty yourself and see others as more important than yourself. You know what we need more than anything else? We need to be saved. And you say, well, yes, of course we do. Saved from our sins. No, no. More than anything else, you need to be saved from you. More than anything else, Jesus came to rescue me from me. Because before I became a child of God, Chris McCurley was hurting himself. Chris McCurley was on the broad path to destruction. Chris McCurley was headed for eternal misery. Chris McCurley was a gossip. Chris McCurley lied. Chris McCurley was not a good person. And God had a solution. How about we kill Chris McCurley? Look with me at what Paul writes in Galatians 2:20. I have been crucified with Christ, and it is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself up for me. Discipleship begins with a funeral. It's death to selfie. That is the picture of baptism that we see painted in Scripture. It's being crucified and buried with Jesus and becoming a new creation. It's saying, God, I don't want Chris McCurley in charge anymore. Can you please kill Chris McCurley? Chris McCurley hurts people. Chris McCurley gossips about other people. Chris McCurley acts unrighteous. Chris McCurley only cares about himself. God, please kill Chris McCurley so that the Spirit can fill me and lead me. Let's have a funeral. God, give Chris McCurley a proper burial so that I can live. You see, life and living only finds meaning in a relationship with Jesus Christ. No one else can give you the life that you expect. No one. So many folks are empty because they're trying to find life in things that aren't Jesus. John 10:10 reads, "The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came so that they could have life and have it abundantly." The thief comes to steal. He comes to steal life, and you know how he does it? By handing you a cell phone, by giving you a mirror, and saying, just focus on yourself, by getting you to focus only on yourself. That's what happened in the Garden of Eden, right? Go back to Genesis chapter 3. In Genesis chapter 3, beginning of verse 1, it reads, "Now the serpent was more cunning than any animal of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said to the woman, 'Has God really said you shall not eat from any tree of the garden?' The woman said to the serpent, 'From the fruit of the trees of the garden we may eat, but from the fruit of the tree which is in the middle of the garden, God has said you shall not eat from it or touch it or you will die.' The serpent said to the woman, 'You certainly will not die, for God knows that on the day you eat from it, your eyes will be opened and you will become like God, knowing good and evil.'" So what's Satan doing here? He's shifting Eve's focus. He's attempting to be the loudest voice in her life, because here's the deal with the devil. He has power, but he doesn't have authority. He has no authority. You know, this old saying, you know, the devil made me do it. The devil can't make you do anything. He doesn't have that authority. And as long as you're aligned with God, he can't do anything. He works by consent and cooperation. So don't give it to him. Adam and Eve gave the devil permission to bring hell into their life. And it ruined paradise, right? The opposite of this is Jesus. Remember after he was baptized and he went and was tempted for 40 days in the wilderness? And every temptation he met with the Word of God, the authority of God. The devil tried to get him to shift his focus. But he couldn't make Jesus turn those stones into bread. He couldn't make Jesus jump from the pinnacle of the temple. He couldn't make Jesus bow down and worship him. You know why? Because he doesn't have authority. He has power. He's very powerful. But he doesn't have authority. He needs a vehicle. He needs a carrier. So don't be one. Don't give him that authority. Eve did. Satan's basic lie is, God didn't really say that. And she listened. She allowed the devil to be the loudest voice in her life. And so she takes a piece of the forbidden fruit. She pulls out her iPhone 14 Pro Max. And she gets with the devil. And she snaps a selfie in front of the forbidden tree. And has the caption, just living my best life. Okay, maybe that's not exactly the way it happened. But you get the idea. The devil's basic lie is, you just be you. Just be yourself. Don't be yourself. Yourself stinks. Be something better. Be Jesus. Don't do you. Be Jesus. If anyone wants to come after me, he must deny himself. Take up his cross and follow me. For whoever wants to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Jesus says it's time for a funeral. Death to selfie. Quit looking in the mirror and look to God. Instead of always being full of yourself, be full of Him. There were two guys that were traveling on a plane, and one guy wanted to start up a conversation with the guy next to him, and so they exchanged pleasantries, and it was, you know, kind of small talk, you know, what's your name? Where you from, that kind of thing. And during the course of their conversation, the first man asked the other guy, he said, so what do you do for a living? And the man said, I'm a Navy SEAL. Well, that piqued his interest. So that led to all sorts of questions about being a Navy SEAL. At one point he asked him, he said, so you're not allowed to travel with like a gun on a plane, are you? And the Navy SEAL said, that's right, no gun. The man said, does it make you nervous or uneasy that you don't get to have a weapon with you? And the Navy SEAL looked the man right in the eye and he said, sir, I am a weapon. If you hear nothing else, hear this. Look me in the eye, okay? Just for a second, okay? And hear me when I say this. You are a weapon. You are a weapon. I've looked at the back of the Bible and guess what? We win. You plus God equals a superpower, and you're victorious. But before anything can change in your life, before you can enlist in the Lord's army, before you can even begin to fight, there has to be a funeral. There has to be a death to self. Let God kill you. Bury yourself. Have a funeral so that you can rise victorious and live a resurrected life. Let's pray. Most kind and gracious Heavenly Father, cannot thank you enough for all the people in this room, for the wonderful, wonderful opportunity that you have given them. May they grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. May they seek every day to live a resurrected life, being crucified with you, buried with Jesus, rising victorious. And may they realize that they are a superpower with you on their side. We love you, God. We thank you, God. It's in your Son's name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Chris. That was really good. All right. So we do want to make you aware one more time that if you are a guest in the room, we would love to give you a T-shirt. We'd love to give you, if we have any free Chick-fil-A gift cards left, I think we got a couple. We'd love to give those away. So if we missed you, let us know. You guys have about 15 minutes to hang out. Listen, not to run around and be crazy. You have about 15 minutes to just kind of hang out, meet some people, chill. And if you're a guest and you didn't come see me, come see me. We'll give you free stuff. Thank you so much for being here tonight. We appreciate you.